Democrat Mel Watt has represented the 12th District of North Carolina since 1992, but Republican Greg Daugherty wants to change that. He is running against Watt this November, and today he joins us now live in our studios. Thank you for coming. The 12th District takes in part Forsyth County, Guilford County, runs southeast down through Salisbury into Charlotte. So I think one thing I know your opponent wants to know, and certainly some of the voters want to know, is you live in Washington, North Carolina, which is 200 miles away. So how can you represent a district that far away from where you reside?
Cameron, the founding fathers had the wisdom and foresight to put no district restrictions in the federal race, because if there were restrictions, then a legislator from the other party during redistricting could draw a sitting congressman out. Hadn't been much of a problem. The only people that asked me about it are the reporters.
You have run for Congress twice in the first district where you live, so why did you decide to take on the 12th district?
We had a candidate, Ashley Woolard, recruited by the National Party, running in the first district. I looked at the 4th District, hoping to bring B.J. Lawson into the race. Now B.J. came into the race, looks like he'll beat David Price. So we looked around where we had our weakest candidates. That was in the 12th District. So I came in here to win the primary, put up a strong number against Mr. Watt.
Let's talk about some of the things on your platform. You're talking about the need to cut spending and taxes. Tell me specifically, if you're on the federal level, where would you cut some of the spending?
Everywhere. We are heading for a deflationary economic collapse. It's part of the global problem. The Democrats in Washington, D.C., the Congress there, are destroying the American middle class. The Democrats in the General Assembly in Raleigh are looting the middle class in North Carolina. We've got to cut spending everywhere.
You identify yourself as a member of the Tea Party. Has that been an advantage in your campaign or a distraction?
The passion that the Tea Party is bringing to the table this time makes us no longer talk about a wave year like 1994, but instead one perhaps 1972, when Governor Holzhauser was elected, Senator Helms was first elected. The Tea Party is out there. The crowds are getting bigger and bigger each week, and it's going to make a significant difference here in 13 days.
When your opponent, Mel Watt, was in our studios a short while ago, he didn't know your name. What is your reaction to that?
He's a busy man. He's up there in Washington, D.C., part of the problem with the Democratic Congress, and doesn't bother me if he doesn't know my name. The ones I need to know my name are the voters here in 13 days.
All right. We appreciate your answers to our questions. Greg Daugherty, he's going to be back, and we'll answer some of your questions.